You probably know this droid. He's C-3PO from Star Wars. And while he looks like an ordinary cardboard cutout, I've made a few changes on this side, which allow him to move his arms, move his waist, and move his whole body. So now he can do the robot. Making one is easier than you think. And in this video, I'll walk you through all the steps. Now take it away, 3PO. Are you ready? Then let's get science. To make your own 3PO, print out this drawing and this cardboard design. I've added links for each of these in the description below, and they're completely free. You can also print out a black and white version of 3PO if you want to color him in for yourself. But make sure you select print actual size when printing these documents. You'll also need a large cardboard box, 10 pop sticks, 3 skewers, 2 paper straws, 10 zip ties, a hot glue gun, a glue stick, scissors, or a Stanley knife, 2 meters of 3mm thick plastic tube, a 3mm T-piece connector, 8 10mm plastic syringes, and a 20mm plastic syringe. You can find this tubing and connector in the irrigation aisle of most hardware stores, and these syringes at some chemists. Once you've got all these items, you're ready to go. Start by cutting out each piece of the cardboard design. You don't have to cut along the lines perfectly at this point. Next, glue each of these pieces to the cardboard. When doing this, glue the top pieces vertically and the bottom pieces horizontally. This helps to make the final pieces stronger. Now it's time to cut the pieces out. If you're using a Stanley knife, put something down first to protect your table. Get an adult to help you for this step. When cutting out piece A top, cut off this bit, but save it for later. Cut off this bit of piece B bottom and save it for later as well. Next, glue the top pieces on top of the bottom pieces. I've added the word up to let you know which way they should go. Be careful with piece A. You need to line up the bottom edges so that you can still see these red rectangles. Cut the paper straws and use a hot glue gun to attach them to the template. The red rectangles tell you how long the pieces of straw need to be and where they need to go. Don't forget to attach the straws to the bottom of piece B. At this point, arrange the pieces like this so you can start to see how it will fit together. Next, cut the pop sticks and place them everywhere you see a yellow rectangle. Be careful with these pop sticks. Only glue them down on piece B. Don't forget this bit from piece A, which lets us know how long these pop sticks need to be. At this time, cut 8 pieces of pop stick that are each 2.5 centimeters long. We'll need these for later. Lastly, cut and glue skewers to the pop sticks. Cut out this bit of skewer, but don't attach it just yet. And when you cut out these pieces of skewer, only glue them to piece C and piece D. Cut out an extra 2 pieces of skewer that are each 3.5 centimeters long and save them for later. Next, drill or poke a 3mm wide hole through the plunger of a 10mm syringe. Try to make the hole as close to the top as possible. Repeat this for another 4 10mm plastic syringes and then cut off these extra bits of plastic. Tie zip ties around the ends of these 5 plastic syringes. When you do this, slide in another zip tie that's wide enough to fit a skewer. Use a hot glue gun to glue them in place, and then cut off these end bits. Now it's time to attach all the pieces together. Poke this skewer through a 10mm syringe, and then glue the skewer to these pop sticks like this. Slide the zip tie loop of 2 10mm syringes onto this skewer. One on each side. Then slide each of their plungers onto this skewer. Add a bit of hot glue to close the ends of the skewers, but make sure you don't get any glue on the syringe. Slide a new skewer through these 5 straws. This will act as a hinge. Cut off the bit poking out and use a little bit of hot glue to seal the ends shut. Check that it can bend at this join. You'll notice the syringe is moving as you do this. We're now going to make something using the 8 pieces of pop stick and 2 pieces of skewer that we cut out earlier. Slide a syringe onto the skewer and then place it on 2 pop sticks like this, using a hot glue gun to glue them in place. Rest a spare piece of skewer here and then glue 2 more pop sticks here. Once it dries, take the spare bit of skewer out. Repeat all of those steps to make another one. Slide the zip tie loops of these syringes onto this skewer, one on each side. Then slide piece C and piece D through these straws. Next, place this end of these pop sticks onto these skewers. They should sit nicely either side of the skewer, and the cardboard piece should be in the same plane as the pop sticks. So not like this, but like this. Add a bit of hot glue here and here to hold them in place, and repeat this on the other side. This is what you should have so far. You're doing well, let's keep going. Glue the cardboard sides of 2 of these triangles together and do the same for the remaining 2 triangles. Drill or poke a 3mm hole through the middle of piece E. Then add some hot glue to this rectangle on piece E and attach the base of piece A, making sure all the components are on this side. Add some hot glue to these rectangles and then attach one piece F. Repeat this on the other side. For extra strength, add a line of hot glue along these edges. At this point, you can attach your drawing of C-3PO to the front. To do this, glue the C-3PO printout to some thicker card and then carefully cut out each piece. Glue these pieces to the cardboard, starting with the legs, then the body, each arm on the front, and each arm on the back. He's looking really good. We just need to make a base for him to stand on. Cut out 3 cardboard squares that have 20cm sides. Stack these squares on each other and drill or poke a 3mm hole that's 7cm from the top and 10cm from each side. Add another hole that's 2.5cm from the bottom and 5cm from one side. Cut another 2 pieces of skewer 3.5cm long. Add some glue to one of these squares and some hot glue to each hole. Slide these skewers into each hole and then slide on another cardboard square, making sure you line up the holes, and then press down firmly. Repeat this step one more time, adding a layer of glue, some hot glue around the skewers, the last cardboard square, and pressing down firmly. Slide piece E onto this skewer and the zip tie loop onto this skewer. At this point, check that all the pieces move freely as you push and pull the plunger in each syringe. Once you finish, push all the plungers back in. This is important for the next step. Cut 2 pieces of plastic tubing 50cm long, 2 pieces 20cm long, and 2 pieces 10cm long. Attach one of the 20cm pieces of tubing to the 2 10cm pieces using a T-piece connector. Then attach the other end to the 20ml syringe. Attach the 2 50cm pieces of tubing and the remaining 20cm piece of tubing to 10ml plastic syringes. Fill 4 cups with water. If you want, you can add 10 drops of food coloring to each cup. Draw up some water into a syringe attached to 50cm of tubing. Turn it upright and squeeze out any air bubbles. Then draw more water into the syringe until it's full. Attach this tube to the syringe that moves the right arm, like this. Then draw up some water into the other syringe attached to 50cm of tube, remove any air bubbles, and attach this to the other arm. In the same way, attach the 10cm pieces of tube to the syringes that move the waist, and the 20cm piece of tube to the syringe that moves the whole body. C-3PO is ready to go. Let's test each piece. This is his left arm. This is his right arm. This is his waist. And this is his whole body. To finish, add some glue to each of the base pieces and sprinkle some sand on top so that he looks like he's on Tatooine. So how does he work? This design uses 4 hydraulic systems to move the different parts of C-3PO. A hydraulic system is a way of moving a pressure from one place to another. When I apply a pressure to this plunger, an equal pressure is applied to this plunger, making it move. We use liquids in a hydraulic system because they're much harder to compress or squish together than gases. Gases can still move a pressure from one place to another, but if what they're trying to move is too heavy, the gas will compress and won't move the object as much. The same rule applies in water pistols. Applying a pressure to the plunger leads to an equal pressure being applied to the water in the nozzle, which then shoots out the end. Hey, Beck! What? Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time on Silly Science with Simon.